Crosby, Columbo, and Valley. Those crooning vagabonds are stealing all our blondes. Now I know what has become of Sally. And when you turn your radio on, who you're gonna hear? My time is your time. Crosby, Columbo, and Valley. That's a part of the, and this is the story of that period of time and the great songs that were sung. The reason for the ukulele was very important. I used to go to a lot of singing auditions, and plenty in the 50s. And usually when you audition for Broadway shows like South Pacific and all the rest, there's about 100 people online. They give you a ticket number and they call you by number, not by name. And there's a pianist there who plays four bars of a song. You give him the sheet music, and the auditioner says, thank you, next, we'll call you. Or if they say, step over to the side, that's a hot sentence. I never heard that. But anyway, I said I wanted somebody to accompany me without a piano player, so I would, leave. And if I never made it, I wouldn't have to hang my head in shame and ask for the sheet music back, so I could get right out. And so it was. I had to play the ukulele more for competitiveness, more than just to play it in the room. I really feel at this point that I'm in the spirit of Mr. Valley. When river wells call and evening is nigh, I hurry to my blue heaven. This is Rudy Valley announcing. See, when that happened, Valley became the rage of this country. He was the first electrical star that women swooned after. While there were men and women, boys and girls were crazy over Gene Austin, it was not a one-sided romantic affair. Because Valley put into, he didn't even know it, but Valley had a swooning, romantic sexual sound that flooded the heart by the ear. No one, this is only my opinion, no one had a greater popular voice than the early Bing Crosby. Where the blue of the night meets the gold of the day, someone waits for me. Oh, tiptoe by the window.